Okay, so this is where Iron Ball's gin distillery is. It's in Park Lane. So it's just over here. So this is pretty much the basis of what they make the gin out of. You've got lemongrass here, orange, lemon, ginger, and pineapple. Some coriander seeds. And what did you say this one was? Juniper?
Yeah, juniper.
Yeah, that's juniper. But you've actually got to have juniper in the gin to make it considered as gin. So it's just like a black seed. It's just like a black seed, like a peppercorn seed, really, isn't it? Here were like his trial run, so I actually made these before he came up with his full sample. So Toei's got a bit in there. So they're pretty much, that's how many bottles it kind of took to get it right, I guess. These bottles here were also experiments, so you can see how much work's gone into. Actually, here's some more experiments here. Experiments. Okay, so here it is here. This is the big distillation. So here it is. This is where they make the gin. Oh, that'd be a good 20 foot tall, I reckon. Yeah, it'd be at least 20 foot, I reckon. So this is Carson. Carson's the Iron Ball's international ambassador.
That's right, brand ambassador.
So Carson, how long have you been working for Ashley for?
I started working with Ashley in 2015, when we were launching the gin, actually, a little bit before that, probably 2014. We ended up getting the gin launched in August of 2015.
Okay. Yeah. And this is the first place, Bangkok was the first place where you distilled it?
Yes, absolutely. So yeah. Bangkok, we set up those stills outside that you saw before and went through about a year and a half of R&D, doing about 200 different batches of different spirits before we finalized one Iron Balls gin and made it the official spirit that we produced.
Right, so those bottles up the top there, what I shot earlier, they're the ones that are...
Those are all different batches from different...
Yeah. Yeah. They're like the experiments, are they?
Experiments, like, exactly. Yeah. We did like passion fruit distillate, we did, what else did we do? Kaffir lime, we did all kinds of different things that we, never really materialized.
Yeah. 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 So what's the basic ingredients of this gin here?
So we started off with coconuts and pineapples, right?
Yeah.
And so we make basically a wine from that.
Right.
Then we take that wine and then we distill it into a base alcohol.
Right.
Ethanol. And then we take that ethanol, you basically create a vodka from that.
Right.
All gins are basically made from vodka. So you got to kind of start with a vodka or a base ethanol water mixture and then redistill it again. And that's when you add your botanicals. So all gins, of course, are gonna have juniper.
Yeah.
But us being a Thai gin, Southeast Asian gin, we wanted to do some Southeast Asian herbs and stuff in there. So we did lemongrass and ginger as our two main botanicals.
Right.
And then we have also coriander seed, lemon and orange skin, and then, of course, the juniper.
So it's lemongrass and the ginger. That's pretty much Thai entree.
Yeah, that's signature Iron Balls, signature Thai stuff.
Okay.
You'll get lemongrass right in the nose. You'll get ginger on the palate.
Yeah.
If you mix it in like a gin tonic like this, you're gonna start getting the coconut from the base.
Yeah.
And the tropicalness of the pineapple. Really, once it's mixed with tonic already, then you're gonna get those flavors. But the base flavors you're gonna get in the nose is the citronella, the lemongrass, and then the ginger on the palate.
Right. Okay. Cool. And so, how many countries is it sold in?
We're sold in about, I think, 21 markets right now. So that we look at more markets than we do countries.
Yeah.
But we're doing a lot. Our first major importer was Singapore.
Right. Okay.
Thailand. That was the first big one.
Yeah.
And then we got into Malaysia. Philippines is doing a lot now. Vietnam, Japan.
Yeah.
Hong Kong is doing a lot. Australia is doing a lot. And then we have Europe, we have Switzerland and Spain.
Yeah.
We just started up in the Netherlands and France.
Yeah.
So it's really
it's kicking off.
Yeah, we've got a lot of global awards for both the gin and the vodka. The vodka we just launched, actually.
Yeah.
Got a lot of awards, a lot of international recognition.
Okay.
Even the packaging design, we got some awards on the bottle design.
Right. Because you just won a big award in Paris, is that right?
Yeah.
What was that for?
It was the Best New Spirit Award. So it's
really?
So it was really big.
God, that's a good award. That's a big one.
That's a big one, yeah. Yeah. In Paris, at that time, we weren't even available in France.
Right.
So I know I woke up in the morning and I had all these congratulations from all these people. Like,
what's going on here? Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
And so that winning that one in Paris is the best spirit award. Is that for boutique? Is that for a boutique or spirits or pretty
best
much?
New spirit. So it's we're going against 140 other spirits or something.
Oh, really? God.
Yeah, to win was a really big deal.
For us. You got the grand prize. So that's excellent. Yeah. Wow. And so what's the basis pretty much behind the bottle? Like, this is the bottle here.
So
you can just show it.
So you'll see this bottle. This is very much Ashley Sutton. It's a ship captain's bottle,
yeah.
Right? So that being said, it's designed to be on a ship, and ships are always yawing and pitching back and forth.
Okay, right.
So the bottle never flip over; it'll just slide.
Oh, right, because they used to make them back in the pirate days, didn't they? Because they wouldn't sink.
They wouldn't. Well, they won't flip.
Oh, that's it. Right.
They won't. They, you know. The
it's a buoy.
It's kind of a buoy at one point, but it's also if you can see it on the table here, it just slides.
Okay, right. Yeah, right. Oh, so it never, you can't.
Yeah, it can't.
Wow.
Yeah.
So there you go. So it's it's good if you've had too many one night and.
Yeah, if you hit some rough seas.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So for a boat, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
When it's going over the big waves.
Yeah.
Your gin survives.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
It just slides around.
Yeah. And how much is a bottle? What is that, a 700?
700 ml.
Yeah.
So we retail the bottles for 1,800 baht.
Yeah.
Yeah, the vodka we retail for 1,400.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And so people can buy it internationally?
You can buy in, there's a lot of duty free are carrying it now.
Yeah.
Depending on what city you're in, you can look on our website, ironbottles.com.
Okay.
And you'll see a list of where we are retailing.
Yeah. And the basis of the still, this is the only place where you make it here in Thailand, or
yeah. This is the our main production is here.
Right.
We will expand to Southeast Asia at some point.
Okay. And how many bottles do you distill at a time?
We can it's about there's different batches that are always running at the same time.
Yeah.
But in a month we do about 3,000 bottles.
3,000 bottles. Okay.
About 2,800.
Yeah. Okay. So it's sold in most bars in Thailand, in Bangkok, isn't it?
Yeah. Bars and hotels all over Thailand.
Yeah.
Sure. Almost all your 5-star hotels are going to have it. And I mean, any decent cocktail bars are going to have it for sure.
Okay. And how long does it take for a batch to process?
From start to finish, it's about 15 days.
Yeah.
So we're looking at about 10 days for the fermentation process.
Yeah.
We make the mash, we add the yeast. It takes about 10 days for the yeast to eat all those natural sugars that are in the mash.
Yeah.
Convert that into alcohol. Then it has a resting period of about 3 days.
Yeah.
Well, we let the yeast die, basically. It's called the clarification process. The yeast settles down. And then you got a couple days of one. We do one day of the initial distillation is one day. They basically make the vodka. And then, boom, we do a second distillation to take that base ethanol.
Take the alcohol out of it. Or the ethanol.
Make it into a gin.
A legal one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have a very good system for cutting. For people that know a lot about distillations, we have heads, hearts, and tails. So heads is going to be pure methanol. The hearts is what you want is ethanol.
Yeah.
And the tails is kind of like, it's got a lot of, much lower alcohol percentage, and it can be a bit gamey. So it's usually the tails we just reuse.
Okay,
the heads you throw out, or you can use them for motorbike fuel.
Yeah, right. Yeah, okay, right. That strong, is it?
Yeah, it's methanol, so it's poisonous.
And, what percentage is it?
We're running at 40%.
Yeah?
Yeah, by the label, yeah.
And you bottle it all here too?
Or we bottle it all right here in house.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. You know, we have our little slogan down here at the bottom.
You've got to have balls, isn't it?
You always have options if you have balls.
Yeah, well, that's right. Yeah, that's a very good slogan, actually. Yeah. So it's an Ashley Sutton design, isn't it?
Yeah. Ashley's Wild Mind makes this sort of thing. So,
yeah. And he's a man behind Maggie Chew's, Sing Sing, Iron Fairies.
Iron Fairies.
What else has he done around Bangkok?
Ophelia in Hong Kong, Jay Borowski here and in Hong Kong.
He did the Holiday Inn upstairs.
Holiday Inn,
the rooftop up there.
Yeah, Hong Kong.
So he's an engineer really by trade, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a craftsman. Yeah. So he does a lot of things with his own hands. He's a very hands-on guy.
Oh, yeah. He's definitely not an idiot.
He's
very clever. He's very clever man.
He is indeed.
Okay, so if people want to come here, you're open from what time?
This bar's open from 6 to 1.
Yeah.
And the parlor bar is open from 7 to 2.
Okay, so the parlor bar is over near Sing Sing?
Yeah, the one near Sing Sing.
Yeah, which I'll be going tonight to. Yeah. It's on Sukhumvit 44?
45.
45, sorry, yeah. So if they want to come here, they can come here from 6 to 1, is it?
Yep.
6 to 1. It's on Sukhumvit, sorry, 60?
63.
And it's in the Park Lane.
Yeah, Park Lane. It's a little, just a little kind of beauty mall here.
Yeah.
It's hidden away. So you'll find it. You'll just see the big glass house up front for the distillery.
Okay, excellent. Yeah. Okay, that's perfect. Yeah. Well, Carson, thank you very much for your time.
It's my pleasure.
It's excellent. Cheers. So might as well have a gin now.
Yeah, fantastic. 60 ml gin.
So 60 mils in there.
Yeah.
So what's that like? Double.
It's a little bit better than a standard pour.
Yeah.
But this gin is so nice, you can drink it straight. So.
Right.
No such thing as too much.
So what's that? Just tonic water, is it?
It's a fever tree elderflower.
Yeah.
It's a little bit. We got some mangoes.
Yeah.
A little bit. Basil for you. Right. Slice of mango.
Oh, nice. There we go. Cheers.
Cheers, Jonny.
All right. Oh, it's so smooth, isn't it?
It's all right, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, it's cunt. Yeah, that tastes like very good. Might be a drink. I'm a vodka drinker, but
well,
I might be onto the gin now.